Good morning. It's 9:10 in the morning. It's a Tuesday. It's my day off. The fire ban in Denmark has been lifted, so we can have a fire in the forest now. We can cook food, make coffee. So I thought today should be about fire. My plan for today, and I might change it due to the weather, it has been raining non-stop for 24 hours and a lot of rain showers the days leading up to the massive rain shower. So the forest is soaked, absolutely soaked. Everything is soaking wet. So I have a plan to go pitch up my tarp. Make a long fire. Obviously, I'm gonna get a lot of firewood to maintain it. Cook some food. I brought a big steak and some sausages and some bacon. Cook up some coffee. Have a beer. And the mosquitoes is out, so a little bit of bug spray. They're already biting. Bug spray and out. Hoping that the bug spray helped. Threw my hat in the dirt. I hate mosquitoes. But like I told you, I don't know if you can see this, but everything is soaking wet. Not that it's gonna bother me, because I brought a tarp to stay dry. I brought an spare tarp to sit on. I brought my wool blanket for the comfort factor. So if it turns out that it's raining today, we will just stay under the tarp and drink coffee and listen to the rain. Yeah, my bag is killing me today. Super heavy. Extra water, beer, food, tarp, grill, axes, saws. Mr. Malsack, you need to get back. Ooh, I cut the beard. This is the Bushcraft Beard Lightweight Edition. joking. But I'm gonna go find a place to pitch the tarp. Yeah. But look at the scenery. Matching colors to the forest, and nothing here is dry. Whew. I'll see you when we get to camp. It's a different sight. I have been here a lot of times in the snow, but the last 2 or 3 months in Denmark, it has been extremely dry, not even a drop of rain. And today, all the leaves in the trees above me are soaked, and every time there's a small blow from the wind, it just empties a lot of water down. So the forest floor is soaked as well. This is my old campsite. Everything is here right where I left it. Nobody has been here. And I'm wearing too much clothes today. I'm already too warm. But we're gonna pitch the tarp, and we're gonna collect some firewood And then we're just gonna build the fire at my fireplace right here. We're gonna clear away all the leaves and all the branches so that there's no chance of nothing touching the fire. Can you hear it? Tarp, firewood, and spend some time here. My original plan was to go somewhere and camp and camp on the ground, but everything is soaked out here. So we're gonna spend some hours here and have a good time. Can't believe it's that wet. What a mess. I planned to film the setup of the tarp and a lot of other stuff, but when rain is coming down, sometimes plan change. I have been here before, I know the forest, I know how to use and work this area, but I'm a bit off my game today, so the knots were teasing me, but I'm no worse for wear, nothing is wet. Let's assemble the rest of the stuff at camp and then get cracking on some firewood. The rain has died down a bit, so that's a good thing, and I hope the video quality is turning out okay, because there's absolutely no light in here today. Nothing. Assemble the camp and get cracking with firewood. I use these table discs a lot. 1, 2, and 3, and they do me very well. It's a nice thing to to raise your stuff up from the forest floor. So that not all your stuff has to get wet. That's a nice thing. And they don't weigh a lot when you bring them. And different places where I camp, I can make legs for them and just pound them in. But not always do they keep standing. So a small arrangement of discs makes for some great tables. Let me see here. Yep. Everything is soaked to the bone today. So I figured that I'd show you what I brought today. Gloves. This is just my rope bag for paracord. Coffee grinder. A coffee cup. A small gear bag with a lighter and a bottle opener. I brought my twig stove, my bush box. I'm not gonna use that today. I also brought a cookser. I don't know what we're gonna be using, but I have a small tripod, gorilla pod, for my cell phone. Coffee pot. Tinder bag. Food and beer. Silky saw. Belt axe. Water. Oh, and my grill. So, I know that a lot of this stuff is not something that you need to have or need to bring. But it helps me through the day to... I know you don't need two axes, and I know you don't need... a coffee grinder, or I know you don't need nice high quality gloves from Krud in Sweden, but this is my hobby, and not only a hobby, it's a part of my lifestyle. So people who play golf, or people who collect stamps, or people who have an interest in fashion, or cars, or watches, spend a huge amount of money on other products. But a simple life in the forest is perfectly fine, but I like using the gear, and it gives me a nice feeling inside. So we are all packed out and ready for some firewood. So, that tree is completely dead and has been there ever since I came to this forest the first time. So today I'm gonna take it down and I'm gonna use it for firewood. It's semi-punky, but I think the most of it will be excellent firewood. So, how to take down a tree? Superman would just kick it, but unfortunately that's not me. This is the Silky Saw Big Boy 2000. This is an amazing saw. It's over 1 year old, I think, almost a year old, and it's still sharp. I learned a lesson a few months ago. I cut myself on this saw, and it didn't hurt, but the saw was so sharp that it cut a deep hole in the bottom of my hand. So I'm wearing gloves. These gloves, perfect. Thank you, Krud in Sweden. Awesome gloves. So, silky saw, a nice pair of working gloves, a cap. You don't need a cap, but nice gloves so that the grip on the saw is perfect. And besides the saw, I'm just gonna put it down so I'm not gonna step on it. Besides the saw, I'm using this. This is the Grandsfors Brook
I'm not a big guy in I'm not fluent in Swedish, but Gransfors, Brooks, Scandinavian forest axe. Sharp as a whistle, nice handle. So we're gonna cut a big notch in the front of the tree with the axe, and afterwards we're gonna come from it behind with the saw. And the tree is leaning that way towards camp, but camp is 50 or 60 meters away, so that's not a problem. But let's get to it. I'm gonna find a good angle and cut it down. Just gonna take the saw, put it away, so I'm not gonna step on it. Clear away some of the big branches on the floor, so I don't step in them and fall in them. And that's the way the cookie crumbles. It is warm. So, firewood is on its way. But it's very warm today and very wet. Thank you.
Sometimes firewood is easy. And sometimes it sucks. So today is cheating. These are fire starters with some kind of flammable material inside. And today I'm gonna make a long fire. I brought a lot of tinder, dry tinder, to make sure that today would be no problem. These are boxes or small pieces of wood that I use for my wood stove, my bush box. But today they're going to help me start this fire. Today, my plan was to build a long fire, so I made two log cabin fires, and I'm going to lead them together. So while this is building up,
My plan was to collect a bit more firewood. That was a lot of work. A lot of work. Let me just flip my screen so I know what I'm doing. But a lot of work. But the fire is going great. The firewood is dry and flammable.
I am sweating through my cap like you wouldn't even believe. It's almost 11 o'clock. I got 6 meters of firewood just ready to cut and throw on the fire. So now it's about time, I think. Stone Street IPA. Can't wait to taste this. My cap is soaked, beyond soaked. I don't know if you can see this, but this is sweat because it's that hot. But look at this. Actually, this is my first long fire. It's not that long. It's twice the size that I usually make, but that's gonna keep burning, I promise. And then it's time for the beer. Just thought that I would take you in here with me under the tarp. Have a look at this. Perfect. We needed that. So just some alone time by the fire in the rain, just by myself. All the fancy restaurants in Europe, America, charcoal steak, charcoal ribeye, charcoal sirloin steak, wagyu steak, they can kiss my, whoop, no swearing in the forest, Thomas, but they can kiss my best bit of coals I ever made. So, just like I told you, the best bed of coals I have ever made. It was a big fire as well, so I get it, but this is gonna be epic. So it's very, very hot. So one, two, three. Hey, so my friend, I call him my friend, Joe Robinette, from Canada, has a big YouTube channel. He says, if you can hold your hand 3 seconds over the coals, they're not ready to cook yet. I can't even get my hand close. We're gonna let the grill fire up, and this is gonna be epic. Yep, sizzle away. So, while my steak is cooking, I will dry out some tinder. And build the fire. I will dry out some tinder and build the fire over on the other side when I'm done. But my small Hultafors axe is, even though it's very sharp, it's maybe a bit too much going through these. A bit much.
juicy.
So, one, two. This beast is dripping all over the place. Normally, when you go to a fancy-pansy restaurant, you are presented with a steak knife and a fork. So, epic and hot. Stone Street IPA, round two. The steak is well done. It doesn't matter. The coals were good. So, no seasoning, and juicy. This is good. Last time that I cooked food on a camping trip, it was on a gas stove at the beach, and it was dry food, spaghetti bolognese. Not that spaghetti bolognese is bad, but epic. I'm gonna finish this, and afterwards we're gonna cook dessert. So, spontaneous decision, we decided to cook dessert while we were having steak, because the steak is perfect.
don't need to do anything about the steak. But for dessert, oak fried bacon around the steak. And if you could taste heaven, this would be it. Oh, I love the pigs. I really do. Oak fried bacon. And charcoal made of oak. These are for flipping bacon on the grill. It's extremely hot. Steak and bacon. Wow. So, my battery is flashing at me. Camp is in the background. The steak was good. The beers were excellent. But it's still wet and the rain is still coming. So I think I'm gonna be signing out for today. It was a pleasure having you. It was a pleasure making this video. I hope that maybe you enjoyed what you saw, and if you did, please feel free to comment below if anything comes to mind. Otherwise, signing out for now. I'm practicing looking at you instead of at the screen. This is me looking at the screen and looking at you. So, signing out for now. Thomas outside. What a day.